So what is meant by the quality of lighting? For the last 20 years or so, the entire lighting dialogue has been around watts, which have nothing to do with light, and watts per square foot, which also are not a measure of light or lighting quality. So to this end, a great effort has been made to shift the dialogue into the quality of lighting, and for the first time, three organizations, the Illuminating Engineering Society, the IALD, International Association of Lighting Designers, and the American Lighting Association have joined together to create a document to bring together the primary tenets and the core tenets of lighting quality. And they are lighting for human needs, lighting for architecture and building issues, and lighting for the environment and economics. Together, the dialogue changes and shifts to where lighting really should be. So let's explore them. So the first core tenet of lighting quality is about lighting for human needs, and that brings us to the area of visibility. And for visibility, obviously, we want people to be able to see and perform their visual tasks, so we need lighting to overcome the problems with contrast, size, and speed and accuracy, while also allowing for the age of the observer. How do we know how much light we need? We actually access the IES handbook, which is a document that tells us how much quantity of light we need, and in it are also expressions of lighting quality. But also recently published is DG18, the Design Guide for Light and Quality. And in this document, we see the important aspects while also providing not just for visibility, but also for mood and atmosphere, for comfort, for the health, safety, and well-being of people, and for social interaction and social communication. The subject of quality and lighting is not complete just by resolving task performance issues and human comfort. There are also architectural and building considerations. And for that, we want to make sure that we've attended to the architectural style and composition of the space, and that we've also allowed for the codes and standards for human safety, and that we've also allowed for material security in the space. Thirdly, there's economics and environment, and to really understand that, we have to make sure that we've allowed for installation and maintenance in the system, that the control system is operating and that it's commissioned properly to perform as the occupant desires, and lastly, that in fact the system is sustainable. And by sustainable, I mean that it meets the requirements of the building occupant while also providing the least environmental impact. And in lighting, this is very clear by providing system efficiency, by reducing toxicity, and by reduction of waste largely through going to longer life products. So quality in lighting is certainly more than just providing for illuminance and the watts per square foot in a space. We also need to provide for proper visual performance. We certainly want the lighting to be appropriate for the brand image of the occupant. We want light to provide for human safety and material security. And of course, we want to do that all with an aesthetic sense that is composed for human comfort and well-being. If we've done this correctly, we've actually enabled the power of light to transform space.